I'm here with NBA great John Amaechi. I caught up with him. He's doing a great job at the Olympics, working for BBC. And we talk about basketball and much more.
When did you know you had that talent to do play-by-play like Stu Lance?
Let's face it. I get the job because there is nobody else at the moment to do it. So every 4 years, they dust me off and throw me in there.
And what's it like to watch Team Britain do amazing for 39 minutes and then drop the ball literally every game the last minute? What's going on?
I'm frustrated with it. I don't know what to say. I'm getting a lot of stick for being critical, but I think they're better than this. They're better than playing almost a whole game.
And I have to ask you this. A shocker today, Russia beat Spain by 2 points. The U.S. almost lost to Lithuania. What's going on here at the Olympics?
Parity. People are catching up. Russia's always been a good team. They've got Andriy Kirilenko. He can do everything, offensively and defensively. And Lithuania played their own game. They played solid, and America played like they were going to play Nigeria again.
Now, you personally, you became super famous. You wrote your book. Mm-hmm. You were the first gay player to play in the NBA.
Well, there are plenty of others.
How's your life changed since writing the book and still doing all the interviews?
Not a lot, really. I mean, most people in England find sexuality pretty boring.
So it's care. But in America, the story
it's the only story. But that's what happens when the politicians who are vying for power still think that sexuality is a way to get elected. Or at least making fun of people's sexuality.
You just told me there are others. Do you know that as a fact, or you just?
Of course, it's not.
Really, other NBA players that are gay but are scared to come out for obvious reasons.
How is that rocket science? That's not rocket science. There's plenty.
But they're not admitting it, or they're not saying that they are.
Some of them are out to their families and friends, and
really?
Just not out to strangers. That's normal. That's how most gay people are out.
What would you tell your fans from Utah and your fans in other places in the NBA at Orlando?
So what would I tell the three people who are fans of me in Utah? About what? I would tell them that all those places that I played are a big part of my experience and of who I am today, and I'm really... Despite the fact that it never really worked out how I wanted it to in Utah, for example, I'm really pleased that I went there. I mean, so many good people that I met, so many people who are appreciative of what I brought to the table outside of basketball. It was formative for me.
My last question, was it tough being gay in the NBA? Was it impossible, would you say? Or
it's not impossible, it's just lonely. You just don't have anybody to celebrate with, nobody to cry on the shoulder. It's difficult, but I managed it. Plenty of other players who are much better than me are managing it now.
Speaking of which, who's the best player in the NBA right now, according to John Amaechi?
That's probably LeBron James, I think. It's got to be. I mean, he's remarkable.
Better than Kobe?
I mean, there's so little difference, it's not even important. The difference between those two is so tiny, it's how good I was. That's how tiny it is.
Stay tuned for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ali Sekvak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekvak. Are you on Twitter?
Yep, @John Amaechi.